Yeah.
Boy. What? We off the grid, this for my kid.
All right, guys, so we just made it to another vlog, but this time we are in Dallas, Texas. It's my first time being in Texas. And what is more Texas than pickup truck number one? Pickup truck number two. Literally waiting for my ride to pull up, Alec, and we're gonna get this little vacation started. We're gonna get it started. And dude, it's like, honestly, I thought Texas would be hotter, but who cares? So I will see you guys tomorrow for the first full day of my Dallas vlog. All right, guys, so we're in downtown Dallas, Texas. Literally my first time, first full day of Texas. Look at this place. It's very clean, I'll say. We've been to two places so far today. I went to Fiction Coffee, which I'll insert that review right now.
So I made a trip to Dallas, Texas, and immediately needed to grab some coffee. We went to this coffee shop called Fictional Coffee, and I got their secret garden latte with lavender and chamomile. Didn't really taste any chamomile, but the lavender was pretty potent. I got a pumpkin spice donut, which wasn't super special, but still tasty.
And then we also went to this place called E-Bar Tex-Mex for lunch, so I'll also insert that review as well right now.
To a Tex-Mex restaurant in Dallas, Texas. I got their beef enchiladas, and honestly, they weren't really special other than that they were just beef enchiladas from Texas. They were definitely reasonably priced.
And now we're on the way to the Dallas Museum of Art, so I'm excited to check that place out. So I'll insert some clips and we'll see where that goes.
All right, we're in downtown now, and this place already looks incredible. Just look at this. I think we're in the Arts District. That's what we call it here.
All right, guys, so we just finished with the Dallas Museum of Art. I just inserted a montage of like everything that I saw that I thought was cool. So we're standing behind this wall of art, and on our way back now we are going to happy hour. So that's the important part of the day. So I will see you guys at happy hour if I bring my camera. All right, guys, we're here at Dahlia, which is a vibe. Look at this place. So we're drinking these Dahlia cocktails, which is Grey Goose with watermelon liqueur, watermelon, and fresh watermelon balls with my boy Alec Kugler.
So let's try this out. Very fresh, and they said that they use Grey Goose, so that's literally their bottom shelf liquor that they use here.
So this is the viewpoint that Fagan just brought me to. Did you find this? Did you just find this, like, this week?
Nope.
When'd you find it?
Vlada.
Wow, of course Vlada knows the spots.
Yes,
all right, so we are in Texas, waiting for our first real barbecue. So I'm gonna get the iconic pecan, and we're gonna get the beef brisket. I am. And the pulled pork if they have it. Then some mac and cheese, you know, fat boy bean sash. And some peach cobbler. What are you gonna get?
I'm gonna get the pulled pork and the brisket, and I'm thinking the mac and cheese, so.
Fat boy bean sash. So we got, after, what was it? 35 minutes of waiting?
Yeah,
we got pulled pork, beef brisket, the peach cobbler right here, and then the mac and cheese. He said it's better than the potato salad, so let's do a first live review for Alec Foodborn.
Don't be sleeping, we got mac and cheese too.
All okay, right. Let's see
first
the
brisket season.
Thoughts?
Oh yeah.
So gas?
Oh yeah,
good, good, good. I'm so excited to try this. This looks so juicy. We're gonna try the beef brisket right now here. Very good, pretty fatty, but that's what makes the flavor.
Younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze, country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, Mountain Mama.
Okay, guys. guys, so we're at the State Fair right now, the Texas State Fair, and we made it to the Texas Auto Show at the same time with the Rocket League Ford F-150. This is crazy.
I literally follow this guy on Instagram. He follows me back. Look at this. We're in the, is this the Arts District?
Deep Ellum.
Oh, Deep Ellum. Okay. Look at the Star Wars thing over there.
All right, so we just finished at Terry Black's Barbecue, and
what do you have to say for it? What do you think?
I've been there many times, and like always,
it doesn't disappoint.
Never disappoints.
My first time going there, got the beef brisket sandwich, which was incredible. And in comparison to Pecan Lodge, I think this was a little bit more juicy, but I mean, beef brisket sandwich, you can't beat that. So I'll just say that it's a level down from Pecan Lodge, but can't find this stuff in Chicago.
We got Fuglum on the tee, ready to hit 200.
Big,
dude, where did that even go?
I definitely went at least 200, I know that.
Is it recording? All right, it's our last day in Texas, full day. And you know, SERGELATO has the practice of golf with Fuglum behind the camera.
Another one? Maybe one more for the road.
All right.
We're gonna say, yeah, just to make you feel good.
Thank you.
Just to make you feel better.
All right, guys, so I think this is the ending of the vlog. We're in the nicest part of Dallas. Ironically, it's in Highland Park. He just hooked it up.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys next time.
May have found the best brunch deal in all of Dallas. $6 fresh watermelon Grey Goose cocktails that definitely creep up on you. In addition, we had $7 flatbreads, and the one that I got was the fromage. It had mozzarella, ricotta, arugula, and garlic oil. It definitely was cheesy and had a nice brine to it. I recommend getting it. Moving on, we ordered some shots, which had Bacardi and Butterfly pea powder, also pretty smooth. And lastly, we ordered the De La Soul, which had volcanic salt, Patron, and jalapeno. I liked it, but if you're not into spicy drinks, don't order it. Enjoy this place. Get lit. Nobu is a different Nobu, and the statement lives true for Dallas. I decided to get some new drinks, so I started off with a new style martini, and it had an interesting taste. Also, the crispy rice with tuna here is a better value for 6 pieces, and it's $30. For the second and third rounds, I got the Pina Martini and the Cucumber Martini, and the Cucumber Martini was refreshing and very cucumbery. I do have to say that the service here was really bad, but I wasn't in a rush. Overall, always love the Nobu quality, check this place out. Are the best donuts in all of Dallas. They come from Salty Donut, and I ordered a cinnamon cereal milk latte, and the latte was just okay and only tasted like cinnamon. Moving on to the real prize, I got the maple and bacon, which was soft and had delicious candied bacon delivering that sweet and savory punch. As for the dragon and passion fruit, it had dragon fruit infused whipped cream, and it was the best donut that I've ever had. Check this place out. In Texas, you have to get some barbecue. We went to Pecan Lodge, which is rated number one in all of Dallas. I started off with their beef brisket, which was juicy, smoky, packing so much flavor, and the pulled pork was also pretty smoky, but it had its own unique, distinct taste. The pork shoulder was fatty, something that I'm a huge fan of. Moving on to the sides, we got the mac and cheese, which was creamy and cheesy, definitely something that I would recommend getting here over the potato salad. And you can't forget the peach cobbler, which it had its own sweet taste. The peaches tasted fresh, I definitely recommend. We're still in Dallas, I had to go to Terry Black's Barbecue. I ordered their beef brisket sandwich, the Dallas Blonde, and some green beans on the side. Their brisket looked juicy, so we had to put it to the test. And in my opinion, this is the best beef brisket sandwich that I've ever had. It's a little bit more juicy than Pecan Lodge. Check this place out.
Growing like a breeze, country roads, take me home.